When Herbie Hancock was the kid in short pants, his family couldn't have known he would become one of the most influential and revered talents in the entire music world. But they certainly knew he made a mad dash to any piano he saw. When they bought him a secondhand upright, he began an unstoppable run into global culture and onto history's pages. Soon, the child prodigy was conquering classical passages.
I won a contest, and young musicians would audition playing various instruments. You get to play the concerto that you use for the audition with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra.
Down through the decades, every musical innovation, humanitarian gesture, and each breathtaking challenge illuminated his talent. His list of awards, accomplishments, and triumphs stagger the imagination, including an Academy Award for scoring Round Midnight, 14 Grammys, 5 MTV Awards, and record sales that far outdistance the average jazz record. After studies at Grinnell College, Herbie was mentored by Donald Byrd in 1961 and cut his first album.
It was 1963 that Watermelon Man became this big hit. Around March, I joined Miles Davis's band in about May. To have the experience of working with the top jazz group, you know, the Miles Davis group, and then walking down the street and hearing Watermelon Man playing out of everybody's apartments. I can't get better than this.
Having studied engineering, loving gadgets, gizmos, and buttons, Hancock was made for the electronic age.
These instruments were designed for people to use, for people to use.
Right.
You know, it's just a tool, another tool. The way an axe is a tool, an axe can be a tool to cut wood to build a house, or can be a tool to slaughter your neighbor, you know. The same thing, a synthesizer can be a tool to really hurt people's ears or interfere with their lives, or can be a tool to make a really nice sounding instrument that can really affect people in a positive way. And it all depends on the person that's using them.
Beyond his musical life, Herbie is also a devoted husband and father. Herbie and Gigi have been married over 40 years. When they first met in a New York jazz club, Gigi didn't know who he was or that other guy on the bandstand named Miles Davis. Herbie and Gigi have one daughter, Jessica. There is a family culture of concern and philanthropy, and Gigi and Jessica fiercely champion causes that promote the common good. Throughout his career, he's worked with artists of every discipline.
Perfect, it's a perfect blend of classical and jazz.
Yeah, this is the perfect match, I think. Yeah.
When it goes...
Yeah! Right.
The Grammy-winning Imagine Project featured musicians from around the world, and he says the theme of that record was about a path to peace through global collaboration. Herbie is the creative chair for jazz for the Los Angeles Philharmonic Association and serves as the chairman of the Thelonious Monk Institute of Jazz.
I've been involved with the Monk Institute since its inception. It really is an organization that follows a path that's similar, very much in synchrony with my own dreams.
He is also a founder of the International Committee of Artists for Peace. And in July, in Paris, the pianist and composer was appointed a UNESCO Goodwill Ambassador.
I really make a conscious effort to embrace the ideology and ethos of UNESCO on a daily basis, either through my music, my work mentoring young students throughout the world, my faith in and practice of Buddhism, or as an international advocate for peace. The arts are the glue that hold us together, the cultural fabric of our lives.
Sixty years after he dazzled the classical crowd, Herbie Hancock remains in the forefront of world culture, technology, business, and music. The California African American Museum takes enormous pleasure in presenting the Lifetime Achievement Award, musician and composer, to the talented, generous, and elegant human being, Herbie Hancock.